Yes.
Sudarshan, I have a doubt. Can we eat lunch in between?
Yes, of course. Why not? Okay, so I hope my screen is visible to all of you. Is it visible, Mr. Sirtaj?
Yes, boss.
Okay. So, good afternoon, everyone. So, today we are going to carry forward this course that is statistical cosmology using Python. And okay, so this is our sixth session. So, in this course, as we know, I think you remember that in this course we started with the list, tuples, set, and dictionaries, means how do we define the list, tuples, and all in the Python. And further, we also discussed that how we can define the vectors and matrices in a Python. So in the matrices, we also discussed the many kind of operation, like how we can determine the determinant, inverse, eigenvalue, and eigenvectors of a matrix. And also we discussed the two kind of loops in the Python, that is while and for loops. And finally, we also define the function in Python using the def and lambda. So these two, there are two more notation to define the function in Python, and these are the def and lambda. And also we discuss the different kind of conditions. These are if else and if else. And finally we discuss that how we can define, how we can read or write file, and also how we can load a file in a given notebook, anything. Okay, so today in this session we are going to discuss a matplot library, so which is very excellent for the 2D and 3D graphics for generating scientific figures, and also it will help us to visualize the data in the Python. And in this session we are going to start with the import matplot, and also we will start with a very simple plot using the matplot library. And further we will see how we can adjust this plot by changing the color of a line or any style, means some dotted, means let's say we have a plot of sine function, that means how we can change the color of this sine wave, something like that. Okay, and also we will see that how we can adjust the axis of a given plot. And finally we will see that how we can label and also how we can label the plots. And also we will see that how we can subplots, means how we can plot the multiple plots in a given plot, single plot. And finally we will see the output. Okay, so now it's time to do work in a Google Colab notebook, so that we can see that how we can work with the matplot library and how we can use the, how we can visualize the data. Okay, so I think my Google Colab notebook is visible.
Yes, it is.
Okay, thanks. Okay, so now the first point, so the first work in the matplot is to import a matplot library. So for this one we are just writing matplot lib, and we just hit shift plus enter, and here you can see that, okay, sorry, it will take time to connect their server. Yes, so we just imported the matplot library, and now let's say I want to know the matplot library version. So for this one I just using this one. Matplotlib. It's not working.
I think you should use double underscore, I guess.
Okay, yes. Sirtaj. So here you can see that
Welcome.
We can see yes. And here we can see the version of a matplot library, which is 3.2.2. Okay, so now so generally we have in this matplot library module we have many sub module of this module. So most of the matplot library utilized lies under a different kind of pyplot submodule. So first we are going to import the pyplot means plot from the matplot library module. Okay, so for this one we have to write and also along this we have to import the another module that is numpy as np. So now let's say we are going to plot we want to plot between x and y. So let's say so for this one I define the x as np, let's say array.
I was just waiting for them. Again, told me, you know, somehow nothing came up to them. I really do not know how to use this.
For this one, let's say I define the x and y, the two array, and I just want to plot these two. So here you can see that we can see a array means we can see a plot between x and y.
So I have a question, Darshan.
Yes.
So do we really need np.array or just any list it will plot?
Yes, it will, but list we can plot means it should be digit, na? Number. Yes.
But okay, so yes. We can have a list, na? So we can have list and there we define 1, 2, 3 in a list and 4, 5, 6 in another list and then we plot x, y. Can we plot that?
Yes. Let's try now. List is like this one?
No, it's a tuple and that tuple. So just one bracket, yeah, enough.
Oh, sorry. Is there a bracket? Yes, Miss Nidhi, we are carrying our this one, no? Of course. You may join if you are available. Yes. Yes.
यार ये बड़ा दिस बैड जस्ट अ मिनट
आई थिंक देयर इज नो प्रॉब्लम इन द लिस्ट सिरताज
यस कंप्लीटली फाइन
आई मीन अच्छा कैन यू जस्ट वेट फॉर 5 मिनट्स.
Yes, sure, sis.
I will send a thing.
It is plotting again the previous x.
Seriously? लेट मी चेक ना
क्या हो गया. हाँ निधि हैज जॉइंड.
No, it's not previous. It is the same thing.
You can see now at the x-axis at x is equal to 3, we are getting the value of 8, right? Yes.
Earlier you wrote an underscore, na? Maybe that's why.
Yes.
So you use arrow if you have number of points, and you use list if you have a small number of points, right?
Yes, means in the list we can define the many numbers. Means I think there is no difference between the list and array at this point in the plotting. We will get the same plot. Yes.
Okay.
So NP array is just the list in the NumPy. Okay, so NP array is just list in the NumPy. If you want to use any function of the NP array list, then you define NP array. Get it? So it's just a list in the NumPy.
Hey Nitin, tell me something. Here this Google, this Microsoft team seems to be a maha pain here. I mean, it's every one of us having problem. It keeps getting disconnected. Tell me something. Did you Google Meet, Hannah?
कोई बात ही क्योंकि नहीं कर रहा है. योर माई नेट इज डाउन.
नो देवतम, वी आर वेटिंग फॉर सम मोर स्टूडेंट. विंसेस टोल्ड अस ना.
ओके ओके ओके.
3 टू 4 मिनट्स. यस,
आई हैव सॉर्ट ऑफ सेंट द मैसेज. सो लेट मी जस्ट सी. जस्ट वेट फॉर 5 मिनट्स एंड देन वी विल स्टार्ट. नो दिस इज बैड हियर. या लेट्स जस्ट वेट फॉर 1 और 2 मोर मिनट्स एंड वी विल स्टार्ट. One by one, people are joining. Ayushi has joined. Hi, Ayushi.
Hi, everyone.
Hi. क्या चल रहा
है? Sir, your voice is breaking. Is it for me only, or
I don't know. Can other people hear my voice?
Yes. Very clear.
Yes. It's a problem with you. Can you hear me now?
Yes, now it's clear.
Okay. Aditi is trying. Aditi is joined. चलो लेट अस स्टार्ट.
ओके सेस, सो लेट मी समराइज अ बिट दैट. सो टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू वी आर डिस्कसिंग दिस मैटप्लॉट लाइब्रेरी मींस फॉर द प्लॉटिंग और विजुअलाइजेशन द डिफरेंट काइंड ऑफ डेटा. So for so first we are just importing the matplotlib library, and in the next cell we can see that we are just printing the matplotlib library version. And also, okay, so for the plotting we have to also import a sub module of a matplotlib library, that is pyplot. Okay, and along this matplotlib library we have to also import the numpy. And here we can see that we are just plotting these two array, and similarly here we are plotting the two list, but we can see that we can see the plot. So next, let's say I want to plot a function. So for this one I am just t is equal to मुझे शांति चाहिए.
तो कौन है?
ओके, सो आई डिफाइन द फंक्शन साइन. So here you can see the plot. Okay, so in the next, let's say I want to, okay, so I think you are getting my point, right? Means I just define the t between minus 10 to 10 with spacing 0.001, and I also define the function sine t, and I'm just plotting the plot between sine function versus time. So let's say in the next, let's say I want to just label these two axes, means on x-axis t and y-axis sine t. So for this one, we are just, let's see, let me copy this cell. Okay, and also in the label we can also use the latex command. Okay, so for example, let's say like this one. Yes, so here you can see that we just label these two axes, and now let's say we want to plot, we want to set a title of this given plot. So for this one, let's say, let me again. Even in the title, we can also use the latex command for it, like this one. Yes. Okay, so I think you are getting my point, right?
No, Darshan.
Yes, yes.
Why are these latex commands are you are using here? I mean,
means this one sign, trigonometry means let's uh-huh. say in the in your
no,
case,
three, you for example, suppose you want to write alpha.
Yes. So I'm just giving a means idea that we can also use the latex command in a label and all. Okay.
Darshan?
Yes, yes.
I suppose you'll be coming to it. Suppose I want to plot cos and sine on the same graph with different colors.
Yes, yes, yes. Okay. Just after three cells, we will see how we can plot. Okay. Yes. Okay. Okay, now let's say I want to change. Okay, so this blue color, na, this one is by default color, but let's say I want to change the color of this sine wave. So for this one, I'm just using like this one. For this one, after function, you have to define like color. This one is okay. So for this black color, you can also use a shortcut that is K. Because for black, B is for the blue. Okay, and let's say I is. Any color you can use. Okay. So similarly, okay. So now let's say, okay. So this sine function, okay. Sine wave is in a line format, na. We are getting just a line, but let's say I want to change their point, means some dash or dot. So for this one, I have to define the marker. So, okay, let me see.
So here you will it join it by default?
Yes. Means no, dotted
in the sense that, can I have this thing about no line points with line joining them? Can I have all three combinations?
But here we can see now, says line and point both are joining.
But suppose I want to put just the points.
Just the point?
Okay. That's the point.
This is, let me check, will it work or not?
No, it is joining it.
Yes.
It
yes.
is dot dots.
No. I see.
Sish, if you want to do that, you'll use plt.scatter.
Plt.scatter.
Okay.
Yes.
Okay. No, just the data points. How exactly to do it?
Just only data point. I hope
Darshan, for that I guess you need to create a list of T versus sine T, only then scatter will work, right?
I think it's a double T, na? Scatter.
Spelling is correct? Sirtaz, I think yes. Now it. Yes, we are getting just a point.
List works as a marker? List?
So here,
in the plot itself, if you use just list.
So here we can see that T is in a list, means from minus 10 to 10.
No, if you do not, if I do not want to use scatter things in the, if I just want to plot it with the list,
no,
as a
no,
list.
If you have a list of two x versus y, you can plot x and y.
Here
the
Darshan, I think there is an echo at your end.
Yes. So,
okay. Let me see. Sorry about that.
So, Darshan, here you can see
an echo. Yes. It is an echo, doko, teenko, charko.
Yes.
Exactly.
No, no, no. Pachko. Yahan pe pachko hai.
Okay, so for this one, let me give you a shortcut. Says so for color, we just type this dot, so it will
blue
give
dot,
all level. Yes.
Okay.
So I think that what you are thinking. Yes.
No, but this will also join it, right? This one only scatter will not join it.
These are scatters. Let me show you like this one.
No.
Let's say I have some point like this one.
No, she is asking.
No, but you did not put scatter, na? You have commented the scatter.
If you use plot, then it will join the dots. If you use scatter, it will not join the dots.
But here you have PLT plot with not scatter, still it is joining. This is not joining.
Yes. With PLT plot, we are also getting the scatter, no?
That is the point. That is what I asked. It can be done using plot.
No, just one minute. Suppose I say plt.plot tfun. Oh, I see. So you don't say color or anything here.
No, sir. So this one color is B. So let's say.
No. My point is the following. Suppose I say plt.plot t.fun.
Okay,
sir. Comma, marker equal to dot.
Okay. With
it
this one,
join we... it, right?
Yes, says join karega wo saath mein.
Now, can I just give just the dot in the quote? Suppose I remove R.
Okay.
I think the real question is what is the difference between plt.plot and plt.scatter?
Yes.
Darshan, can you just remove the dot from the plt.plot?
Then we will get a by default, no? That is line space.
Haan, karo to sahi ek par.
Okay, man. Yes.
Yeah, okay. You can even just use the dot instead of b dot. Just use the dot.
After?
Yeah, I think that's what I wanted
use
to do. Yeah.
plt.plot e, comma, fun, dot. Just use
then we will get a scatter plot.
Yes.
I see. So if you say marker equal to, then it will join. If you don't say it, you just put the plots dots.
So instead of dot, if you put a dash, what would happen?
Dash will be black.
Yes.
And suppose you put a dot and a dash, what will happen? It's called Morse code.
Yes.
Oh yeah, actually it doesn't ring. Oh, I see.
This is beautiful.
Can you put any?
So here are many options. Yes, we can use S, D, P, D, H, and so on.
Wow.
You can see 1, 2, 3 and star.
ABCD नहीं है?
अपनी शक्ल नहीं है D है डायमंड देवोत्तम
ओ गुड ओके दिस इज यूजफुल आई मीन नॉट द अदर थिंग्स
सेस नॉट सेस बी सेस सेस स्केयर
as if one sesh was not bad enough you know
But we, I and Devotam are diamond. Yes.
Okay.
So this line style, I think we already got.
Yes.
So, okay, let's say we want to control this width of sine wave, no? Means this is thick. So let's say we want to get more. thickness. So for this one, we are just plotting. So you can control the width of this one using by defining the line width in the keyword of PLT plot. Okay, so here you can change 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 as per your choice. Okay, so now let's say I just okay, so now let's come to the sales question that we, let's say we want to plot the sine wave as well as the cosine wave. Okay, so for this one, defining the two functions. So here you can see that sine and cosine wave on a single plot, but let's say we want to know that which curve is correspond to the cosine or sine wave. So for this one, we have to label these curve, no?
Yes.
So or yes. So for this one, let me again see. So for this one, I am just labeling these two curve.
Okay.
So for this one, we have to type a one command that is legend. Sorry, spelling.
END or AND?
END services. Okay, so here you can see that blue. Okay, so here we can see that blue one is correspond to sine wave and this yellow is correspond. Okay, so now the next
is great.
Yes. So now let's say so here we can see that this labeling is over the curve, but we want to shift this label, okay, somewhere. Means, okay. So, but here we are not getting any much space to put sine and
just cos. Say sine and cos.
Yes, yes. Okay. Okay. So it is automatically shifted to the empty space.
Oh, it sort of looks for the most empty space available and shifts there. Okay.
Yes, yes, yes. And
manually, how to do it?
So for this one, we have to define the location like this one. Let's say upper left, right. Yes. Yes. And also,
can we define the coordinates of legends?
Absolutely, Nidhi. We will discuss. Yes, Nidhi. Just after one cells. So, but before that, let's say we have a very big label, no? Let's say sine functions and all means again. Now, but in real life, the label can be very big, no?
Yeah.
So for this one, let's say how we can create an empty space to put the long label in a plot. Okay. So there are two methods for, as I know, but so for this one, Yes. So for this one, okay, let's say this x, y-axis is from minus 1 to 1. So let's say I set this y-axis from minus 1 to 2. Then we will get a empty space on the upper cell, no? I think you are getting my point, right?
No, no, no. Just a minute. Okay. Sorry, I missed it. Acha, there's a new... Okay. So you want to force it to plot in a range.
Okay. Okay, so the question is this one. So how we can create an empty space in a plot so that this long label can adjust itself?
No, that probably you just have to make an appropriate range, right? Of the y-axis.
Yes. That's what I mean.
Okay.
Here you can see that. Okay, so now let's come to the Nidhi's point that how we can define the coordinate of a given label, means a coordinate define kar dete hain aur wahan fir label apne aap chala jayega. Yes, for this one. So let's see. Okay. So yes, here we can define the coordinate 1, 1 means 1 is full x-axis and another one is full y-axis, means it's just turn on. So for this one, we can also control like this one. 0.7 and all. Okay. Yes. So using the coordinate, we can also control the location of a label.
Just a minute. Yes, so what yes. Did you put? You put plot legend. Previously, you just put legend. Now you're putting, you put a box around a B box.
Yes.
And where is it placed, you are saying, to anchor? And 0.71. What is point 0.71 is what? I mean, what position is it?
Okay, it says, okay, first let me.
These are the coordinates, right?
If you just see x versus y. Yes, yes. Means this is a scaled, yes. Means the total x-axis length is equal to 1 and total y-axis length is equal to 1. Another one.
No. These are the coordinates of which corner of the box?
Boss, just imagine, forget about the x-axis, whatever the things are, like minus 10 to 10, forget about that. Just think that the whole x-axis is normalized to 0 to 1.
Oh, I see. And okay, y-axis is okay, normalized fine, to fine, 0 fine, to fine, 1. Fine. I agree. Yeah. Okay.
Yeah. Thanks.
Yes. So if you just 0.5, can you just put in? We can check.
Yeah. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. At the center. So we can adjust anywhere. No? So now I think you got the point that also we can control. Yeah, we can define the axis, y-axis, different type of color, width and all. So now let's say we have to plot the grid. I'm just turning on the grid. Yes.
Okay.
Because sometimes grids will help, no? On, let's say we want to track on a particular value of.
Okay. So that's
at a given. Yes, yes.
So if you put two plot commands, by default it plots on each other, is it?
Yes.
No, the reason I'm asking is because MATLAB, for example, when you put two plot commands, then the second one overwrites the previous one, unless you put a command called hold on in between.
Oh, but says in Python, there is a by default command is that it will just overlap these two.
Means okay, not so if it is to be on different ones, it has to be told.
Hmm.
Okay. So default is opposite here.
Yes, okay. Yes. So this feature is just by default in Python.
Okay.
Yes. So here we can see, but let's say we want to resize this image. Okay. Means thodi badi chahiye matlab image. So for this.
समझ गया यार resize हाँ बड़ी
चीज. Okay. So for this one, I just define. So also we can, yes, there you can.
Okay. तो यार दिखाओ क्या लिखा तुमने.
Yes, yes.
Oh, you are just saying by what factor? Nee, what is 10? What is 8? Not a factor.
I think right? These are in inches. Inch, na? Says.
Hey, this is not 10 inches here.
Sorry, sir.
ये तो पता नहीं कितना बड़ा लैपटॉप है तेरे पास.
इसे हम कंट्रोल कर सकते हैं बट मुझे एग्जैक्ट स्केल नहीं पता बट क्या
दिस इज समथिंग इंटरेस्टिंग. ओके आई सी. ओके
10 इज सम हॉरिजॉन्टल लेंथ एंड
तू ऐसा कर तू 10 को 1 कर दे देखते हैं क्या होता है.
1 से ज्यादा छोटा नहीं हो गया. यस यस
आई सी. सो
इट्स x कॉमा y.
Just yeah, so this is a unit size actually.
Yeah.
I see. So whatever it is, maybe 1 centimeter.
Hmm.
But yeah, 15 centimeter bhi to nahi hai na. Oh, acha, pata nahi. Jeff, pata nahi. Theek hai. Okay.
Okay. Okay, so next, let's say I want to save this output in
it's
my.
It's in unit inches.
Inches.
Unit inches. That's
what. अरे यार उसके लिए तो दर्शन का फिर लैपटॉप कितना.
इंचेस तो हो सकता है बस.
इंचेस का
इंच नहीं इंचेस नहीं होगा. It should be. I guess either it should be in centimeters or it should be in pixels. It's a unit, so maybe when it displays it, it automatically scales it to your display, but when you will take it into print or save it, then the size would remain.
Okay,
possible.
Okay, so next, let's say I want to export this image. It means I want to save this image. So for this one,
okay.
And this is very important. Means also you can save on the right click, na? Save image as.
Acha, it'll be a PNG file, is it?
Yes, yes.
Okay.
But now let's say I want to save means जो actual इसका जो size है वो मतलब जो actual DPI या जो feature है इसका वो ताकि remain same रहे. Basically, we have to save file.
Okay.
So, ये में से हो गई. So, here you can see.
Darshan, let me get yes, a bit sir. Greedy.
Yes.
Can I save 2 figures? I mean, suppose I plot the sine function. Then I mean, which I have not told as yet. I mean, a default, not a default, command by which it plots cos function in a different graph.
Okay.
And I mean, suppose I want to. So okay. So suppose I want to save these as 2 different figures. What do I do?
Okay. So for this one, first we will plot these into different plot. ऑफ कोर्स शेष मींस हम पहले ना इनको सब प्लॉट प्लॉट करेंगे अभी नेक्स्ट सेल में तब हम देख
चला जाएगा ठीक है ठीक है
हां यस
ठीक है ओके
सो हियर यू कैन सी दैट
अच्छा वन मोर थिंग दर्शन जस्ट वन थिंग सी लाइक यू हैव प्लॉटेड साइन एंड कॉस
यस यस
नाउ सपोज आई वांट टू रब द साइन एंड प्लॉट कॉस व्हाट कैन आई डू I don't want to overplot.
And you want to just a single plot, okay?
Yeah, I have plotted sine. I have looked at it.
Mm.
But now I want a cos plot and only a cos plot.
Then I
then I need to, what I'm trying to say is that then I need to rub off the previous one, right?
Huh.
How do I do that?
I guess comment the sine plot.
Comment is okay.
No. See, for example, I will tell you. I'm running a program.
Yes.
It has plotted the sine plot. I have looked at it. And the program is proceeding and then it gives a cos plot.
I think that's the benefit of working in cells in Python, right?
Sorry.
Shesh, I mean... see, that's the benefit of working in cells in Python. You can run everything by cell by cell, right?
I see.
Whatever.
But if suppose you are writing this into a file,
Python. No, code. I mean my point is, just like languages as in C or C++, where you have to wait for the final result. Run the whole code and then just wait for the final result.
Nidhi, I agree that this is an advantage, but there is also a provision for putting all these commands in a file and running the file the way you do it in a C code.
Yes, that will he will discuss in subplot.
He's
going to discuss in subplot.
I want to overwrite. Okay. I don't want to.
Yes. Okay. So, I think I'm audible, right?
So, you will get a sign, right? Now, and then you can do a PLT course. So, you can overlap this.
No, this will be different though. Yes, Darshan, you are audible.
Okay.
How exactly to get...
So, I think we should wait for Shesh, I think, yes, for some minutes.
Yes.
But I think Shesh was asking this one. Okay, let's say if I plot dot so in between these two plot, then we will get only single plot.
If you do abort,
I think Darshan, instead of after putting plt dot show, you can put plt dot close and then plot cost function. So it will close the first window and then plot the second one.
Okay, you mean this one?
Yes, yes.
But still, we are getting both plots.
Because if
yes, but still we are getting these two plot. No?
Yeah, but it is taking in this memory. No, huh? So
plot.
अच्छा एक तरह ये क्लोज अगर हम नहीं करते हैं व्हाट हैपेंस आई मीन इफ वी कीप ऑन प्लॉटिंग
क्लोज नहीं करते हैं तो आई थिंक दैट विल शो बोथ द कर्व्स इन सेम विंडो
नो 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 मतलब अगर हम डिफरेंट सेल्स में करते जाते हैं और हम क्लोज नहीं करते किसी को भी तो इससे क्या मतलब मेमोरी ऑक्यूपाई ही होती है और कुछ भी होता है
If you don't close it, then it is already there in the background, I think. Once you, because if, like if there are some 10 functions, 10 sine functions, different functions, or if we are not closing it, so those, I think, plot window, they are still open in the memory. So you have to close it actually to save your memory
but
also.
That does not Achha, but other than that, there's no issue.
Haan, there's no issue.
Yeah. I think she's going to be able to see this command. I think.
He said,
क्या है सुरेश का क्वेश्चन क्या है
इन अ सिंगल रन
प्रोग्राम ओके एंड सपोज इट इज गिविंग मी पोजिशन वर्सेज वेलोसिटी ऑफ अ नंबर ऑफ पॉइंट्स प्लॉट कर दिया
okay
now I want to give a tab so that it proceeds further and gives me velocity versus time
bus so you will no sorry you want to do the next step now na so you will need to move to the next cell you don't want to write the script
no you see what I am trying just say okay now okay what I am trying to say is the following suppose I in MATLAB or Octave suppose I have plotting two functions and I can always say plot function one it will plot it then I give a long do loop so that it gets enough time and then comes to the next plot but in the next plot it removes the first one and plots the second one
yes
that is what I mean
okay for this one we can use this one says plot close So it is
that's what I that is exactly what I'm okay. Plot close.
Yes.
That is what I'm looking for. Oh my God, it's an English. Okay, in MATLAB and all it says hold off.
in Python also you can ask a program to wait for some time and then plot the second one.
Yeah, but
I don't
the second
remember
one will
what
be plotted
is the command
on top of the first one, na, which will be done only with this plot close.
But शेष देखो इसके अंदर when he has used this plot dot close the sine thing is not coming up right only cos thing
is coming up. I want to remove the first one and put the second one.
No, but you have not seen the sine function. You said you want to see first both of them.
No. That can be done by putting a delay in between. See, for example,
if it is not a sine function, it is some unknown thing. And you want to compare it with cos, right?
Right.
For that, you need to see both of them simultaneously.
But I can have a situation where I want to see two plots one by one.
But इसमें नहीं आया ना? That is
नहीं,
my point.
इसमें
सिर्फ cos आया.
नहीं. इसमें I will tell you why. Because before you see it, it has gone to the next one. So इसके लिए after the sine. You have to say something like print input something and when you put that input, then only go to the next one.
आगे दोनों आगे से ये देखो साइन और कोसाइन.
इतना बोलने के बाद अच्छा.
I just subplot dots out. Then after that we can see the diff.
Okay, actually this is not what I was asking. I mean this is okay. This will serve the purpose. What I was asking was in the same figure. It yes, first yes. So what I am saying so for
Nidhi, I think that's what he wants to ask. You have a UI, एक plot आए, उसके बाद 2 second का break को, फिर दूसरा plot आए.
Yes, उसके लिए yes, I think exactly. What has to be done is दर्शन.
हाँ, प्रियंका said yes. Actually.
In between after the sine plot, you have to give a command where okay. It will ask for an input and wait, mm-hmm. And when you give the input, it will go to the next one.
Oh, okay.
So since there is something known as a delay in Python, yes. You can do that.
Ah, okay, that kind of a thing. Okay. Yeah. Okay.
Okay. I'll check it.
Oh, yeah. I mean, it is just that I was getting greedier and greedier.
Hold off. Hold off.
Hold off.
It is.
I don't know at this point, but
it is Python sleep function is there, so it sleeps for seconds or whatever you want.
Okay, I see.
Oh.
You need to import time, and you can say time dot sleep, okay. And you can put how many seconds or whatever you want.
So alarm clock will get there.
And after yes. That, it will run again.
Okay.
And if you want to choose what I mean as an input, then you can just ask. I mean, as in, then you need a for loop or switch or something similar to switch. If you want to choose what you want to run next.
This is important. Okay. Yes, yes. I'll check this command and then we will discuss in the next session.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. Good.
Yes.
Good.
Definitely.
Nice. मजा आ गया.
Yes. तो अभी मैटप्लॉट में एक सेशन और लगेगा सेशन जिसमें बाकी हम जितनी भी
क्लासेस.
सो आई थिंक एट दिस पॉइंट वी कैन स्टॉप दिस सेशन.
यस यस. थैंक्स.
ओके थैंक्स टू ऑल. यस.